So recently I was doing some research on the drugs that deplete vitamin D. And I just found some interesting things I want to share with you. Corticosteroids, like prednisone, normally are used as an anti-inflammatory, right? Well, here's the thing. Vitamin D is one of the best anti-inflammatories. Problem is, when you take corticosteroids, you're depleting your vitamin D, creating more inflammation and need for more corticosteroids. Number two, antibiotics. Certain antibiotics block your absorption of vitamin D. And vitamin D is needed to strengthen the junctions of the cells in your colon. So without vitamin D, you create leaky gut. So when you take antibiotics, block vitamin D, and now we're not going to protect the integrity of the gut barrier, increasing our chance of getting autoimmune diseases and allergies and things like that. Now, when someone takes an antibiotic for TB, for example, that creates a vitamin D deficiency. But one of the common treatments that they used for TB before they had antibiotics was cod liver oil and sunshine, vitamin D, because they found that it actually helped this condition. And all those antibiotics that are taken for bronchial infections and respiratory infections, which then block vitamin D, increase your susceptibility of getting another infection in the bronchial area because you're low in vitamin D. So you have a lot of vitamin D receptors in the upper and lower respiratory areas, in your sinuses and your lungs. And they're there because of the extensive immune protection. And the very reason why you even get an infection and you need antibiotics is because you're vitamin D deficient. Now, antidepressants block vitamin D. One of the most therapeutic things for vitamin D is to help you with depression. So here you are taking a drug for depression or anxiety, and it's creating a vitamin D deficiency, thereby making you dependent on that drug. As soon as you try to get off of it, you can't. All right, number four, phenobarbital. This is used as an anti-anxiety and for seizures. Well, guess what vitamin D does? It helps reduce stress, it helps anxiety, and it decreases the risk of seizures. So again, here's a medication, blocks your vitamin D, create a vitamin D deficiency, and now we make it worse. Okay, Dilatin is also used for seizures. Same thing, it blocks vitamin D. All right, number six, cholesteramine. This is a medication that blocks bile, if someone has too much bile, and it also blocks cholesterol. So cholesterol is needed to make bile and vitamin D, and this medication definitely blocks the ability to make vitamin D. So you're going to be vitamin D deficient if you're on this medication. Number seven, we have ulcer medications. A big cause of ulcers is the microbe H. pylori. There's some great research that showed that vitamin D produced a 77.2% eradication of H. pylori, which is going to help the person's ulcer. So I just found it interesting that the reason you would need these medications in the first place is you're vitamin D deficient. The problem is when you take them, you create a vitamin D deficiency. So it's totally logical. So if you have any symptoms, you may want to try taking some vitamin D. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple.
We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.